What's up, friends, and welcome back to another mini PC review. This is an all new powerful AMD Ryzen 5 mini PC from the brand Trigkey. This one is called the Trigkey S3 and it's from their SpeedS line of high performance models designed to handle difficult tasks such as video editing and 3D gaming. It's also great at entertainment features such as streaming movies and TV shows, 4K HDR video playback, surround sound audio output, and PlayStation 2 emulation gaming. In this video, I'll also attempt to install alternative operating systems such as Android x86 and FireOS, and in the end, I'll test its performance benchmarks to see where it places on my rankings chart. So that's up next, stay tuned. So I'm back, and in this package, you get the S3 model itself. You get one 40 inches HDMI cable and a shorter 9 inches HDMI cable. You get a 12 volts 3 amps DC power adapter, a mounting bracket and screws, and a user manual. So the design of this model consists of a plastic upper housing with the Ryzen 5 and AMD Radeon graphics stickers to the top. At the front, it has two USB 3.0 ports, one USB Type-C port, a headphone jack, an LED power button, and a clear CMOS button. To its rear, it has two HDMI display ports, two more USB 3.0 ports, one RJ45 Ethernet Gigabit LAN port, its DC power input jack, and its exhaust vent for its internal cooling fan. To its sides, it has intake vents. And to its base, it has an aluminum panel with two anti-skidder rubber pads, screw holes for attaching the included bracket, and four screws that you can remove to access its SATA expandable storage facility and its M.2 NVME SSD and its RAM modules. So the operating system used in this model is the latest Windows 11, and upon first start you will have to complete the first startup wizard by logging into your internet network and, if necessary, your Microsoft account. Its basic system information shows that its processor is the AMD Ryzen 5 3550H quad-core CPU with a base clock speed of 2.1 GHz with Radeon Vega mobile graphics GPU. It has 16 GB of RAM, and this is DDR4 memory. It's a 64-bit operating system, and under product key and activation, it shows that your Windows installation is activated. For a bit more in-depth information, here it shows that its CPU has a boost clock speed of 3.5 GHz. It comes with two Crucial brand 8GB DDR4 3200 RAM modules clocked at 1600 MHz, and it can take up to 32GB. Its GPU is the AMD Radeon Vega 8 graphics with a boost speed of up to 1.2 GHz. It has 512 shading units with Vulkan API version 1.2 support and OpenGL version 4.6. Its audio adapter is the AMD Radeon HDMI K17.1 high definition audio control. Its system disk is an M.2 2280 NVMe Kingston M.1 500GB SSD with a maximum read speed of up to 2100 MB per second. It can also take up to 2TB maximum. Here, it also shows that it detects my 1TB Western Digital SATA SSD I inserted into its expandable storage facility. It has dual band 2.4 GHz plus 5 GHz Wi-Fi, and its Bluetooth version is 4.0. And that's its system and hardware information. Turning my attention to its display and audio features. For display, you get up to 4K 2160p at 60Hz with HDR. You get screen orientation to portrait mode, reverse portrait, and reverse landscape. You get dual monitor display via its dual HDMI ports, and you can add a third display wirelessly. Its front Type-C port is not a display port. Here is a sample of its 4K HDR video playback.
a win for Barca would be enough because it would give them the same number of points as Atletico.
For audio, when connected to a surround sound audio receiver, you get 7.1 Dolby Atmos, Dolby Digital Plus, Dolby True HD, DTS X and the DTS HD Master Audio formats. And here's a sample playing surround sound audio.
Prepare to experience something spectacular with the sight and sound of Dolby technology. This is Dolby Atmos. Now, sound moves around you in three-dimensional space with breathtaking.
This is the left channel. Next, we have the center channel.
When connected to your receiver, you can also watch services such as Netflix in 4K Ultra HD resolution with Dolby Atmos. For video editing, I loaded a 4K video clip into Camtasia and set the project to edit in 4K, and editing the timeline is smooth with good timeline playback. For testing, its Vega 8 graphics GPU, I installed Destiny 2, which is a 94GB high graphics game on the Steam platform, and for it to play smoothly, I had to lower the resolution to 1080p and set it to low graphics. And for Emulation Gaming, I installed the PCSX 2 PlayStation 2 emulator and it works really well. This is Devil May Cry 2 on a 720p resolution. And this is God of War 2 on 720p resolution. For office applications, you can install Microsoft 360 and gain access to office apps such as Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. Let's now take a look at its benchmarks and where it places on my PC rankings chart. First, I have the results of its RAM copy speed and its Kingston M.2 NVMe SSD read and write speeds. Its 16GB of DDR4 RAM has a RAM copy speed of 24,543 MB/s. Its M.2 SSD has a read speed of 2,523 MB/s and a write speed of 1,762 MB/s. Next, its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN speeds. Based on my network speed of 154 megabits per second, the 5 GHz band and the LAN port achieved the maximum speed of my network. The 2.4 GHz band achieved only 38%. In benchmarking its single core and multi-core performance, it got a score of 896 single core and 3122 multi-core in the Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark. In measuring the performance of its AMD Radeon Vega 8 GPU, it registered a score of 746 in the Trillimark TimeSpy test. And for comprehensive testing, it scored 427,784 in the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 3,478. And with these benchmarks, let's now see where it places on the chart. So the scores are in, and the new Trigkey S3 is at position number 6 based on its PC Mark 10 benchmark score, and this position indicates that it's a good high performance model. So to view the chart, you can do so on my website, where you can compare various benchmarks and features, and I also provide product links and a link to its video right here. For more information, see the link in the description below this video. So that's it for its Windows operating system. And as promised, I attempted to install Android x86 and VidOS on a 1TB SSD inserted into its expandable storage facility. So Android x86 installs without issues, and there is no security boot restrictions in its UEFI BIOS. Here I'm running Android 11 x86 with all features working. However, when you apply Android x86 to a mini PC, there's usually the issue of no audio via HDMI, and the same applies to this model. You can, however, get audio via its headphone jack. And for those who use and follow the development of the FidoOS operating system, I installed the AMD version and it installs without issues. However, I'm not getting audio via its HDMI port, which is a first for FidoOS on any device. Also, I cannot get it rooted using the super user application process. So if you are interested in running Android on Windows hardware independent from its Windows operating system, then I have two step-by-step video tutorials, links to which you can find in the description directly below this video. In summary, the Trigkey S3 is a great high-performance AMD Ryzen 5 mini PC. I had no issues with it, and it's a great machine for work and entertainment. It comes with high-quality components such as crucial RAM modules and a Kingston M.2 NVME SSD. It has SATA expandable storage that you can also use for alternative operating systems, and its internal cooling fan is almost silent while at the same time keeping the system cool at all times, even during gaming. So friends, this brings to an end my review. Thanks goes out to Trigkey for sending this model for review, and if you are impressed with its performance and would like to get your hands on one, you can do so with a $100 discount coupon on the Amazon store page. To take advantage, see the link in the description below this video. So if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you are new to my videos, then hit that subscribe button and ring the notifications bell next to it to keep in the loop as to when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.